Greetings. Let's look at Surah 548. I'm going to look at four translation: the Musin Khan, Yusuf Ali, the Pickthall, and the Sahih International. Let's look phrase by phrase at these four different translations. And we have sent down to you, O Muhammad, the book in truth. Now notice the parentheses. That means these are not the original words. These are something that a translator has put in to imply. Mostly I have removed these interpolations, these additions to the Quran. To thee we sent the scripture in truth, and unto thee have we revealed the scripture with the truth, and unto thee have we revealed the scripture with the truth. So let's agree this claims to be Allah speaking to Muhammad. And let's agree the Allah claims he sent the book, confirming the scripture that came before it, confirming the scripture that came before it, confirming whatever scripture was before it, confirming that which preceded it of the scriptures. The Quran confirms the previous scriptures. This means the Torah, Psalms, and Bible. And a big Arabic word, trustworthy in highness and a witness, over it, guarding it in safety, and a watcher over it, and as a criterion over it. The Quran is a watcher or guard or witness agreeing to and protecting the previous scriptures. So judge between them by what Allah has revealed. So judge between them by what Allah has revealed. So judge between them by that which Allah hath revealed. So judge between them by what Allah has revealed. This tells us to judge between the various messages Allah claims to have revealed. Keep in mind, Surah 547 says the Gospel or Bible was revealed by Allah. To judge between means to use both against the other. And follow not their vain desires, and follow not their vain desires, and follow not their desires away, and do not follow their inclinations away from. This means do not follow vain desires. But the exact meaning of vain desires is not stated. Diverging away from the truth that has come to you, diverging from the truth that hath come to thee, away from the truth which hath come to thee, away from what has come to you of the truth. Now here Muhammad's use of pronouns can create great confusion. If we apply consistent meaning to the pronoun you, this surah speaks only to Muhammad. And we have sent down to you, O Muhammad. So judge, you Muhammad, between them. And you Muhammad, follow not their vain desires, diverging away from the truth that has come to you, Muhammad. But then the audience changes. To each among you, to each among you, for each, to each of you. We have prescribed a law and a clear way, have prescribed a law and an open way, we have appointed a divine law and a traced out way. We prescribed a law and a method. If Allah willed, He would have made you one nation. If Allah had so willed, He would have made you a single people. Had Allah willed, He could have made you one community. Had Allah willed, He would have made you one nation. And here's an editor's comment, united in religion. This can mean one of several things. Allah has given every man his own law to follow. Allah has given all religions of the world as ways to worship. Islam is the only valid religion. Allah has given Judaism and Christianity to the world along with Islam. If you call yourself Muslim, you must reject number one. You cannot believe that each man has his own law given to him. If you call yourself Muslim, you must reject number two. You cannot believe that all religions, including pagan religions, were created by Allah. If you call yourself Muslim, you must reject number 3. You cannot believe Islam is the only religion, because Allah made different communities and laws. He made different religions. So if you call yourself Muslim, you must therefore believe number 4. Christianity and Judaism exist because your Allah has made them, and has made them to reject Islam. Remember, had Allah willed, He could have made you one community. Therefore, Allah willed to make us separate. Now we know that Christians are told to judge by the Bible, and Allah made them that way. But why? But that He may test you in what He has given you. But His plan is to test you in what He has given you. But that He may try you by that which He hath given you. But to test you in what He has given you. This same you is He could have made you one community. He made you different communities. So He made Christians, Jews, and Muslims to test. So strive as in a race in good deeds. So strive as in a race in all virtues. So vie one with another in good works. So race to all that is good. This race is to be to good works. This race is between the communities Allah has created. This race is against Christians and Jews. This race is to good works, not to insults. This race is to good works, not to calling the word of Allah, the Bible, corrupted. This race is to good works, not to calling Jews and Christians apes and pigs. The return of you is to Allah. The goal of you all is to Allah. Unto Allah you will all return. To Allah is your return altogether. This claims when we die, we all return to Allah. Then He will inform you about that in which you used to differ. It is He that will show you the truth of the matters in which you dispute. And He will then inform you of that wherein you differ. And He will then inform you concerning that over which you used to differ. This has several curious meanings. Allah made the differences between Jews, Christians, and Muslims. Allah will only tell you the truth after we are all dead. If Islam were true, it would say, then Allah will confirm Islam. If you call yourself Muslim, realize your Allah claims He made Christians and Jews just as we are. Your Allah has something to tell you, but will only tell you after you are dead. After you die, your Allah will tell you where you got it wrong. Too late. Remember, Surah 547 says the Gospel, or Bible, was revealed by Allah. And remember, Christians and Jews were made that way by Allah. So vie to good works and stop attacking the Bible, which is the word of Allah. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.